Red. Blue.
Interesting. Opposite of the clothing.
Red. Service. This end.
So the table has been set and the food is being prepared. Varsha, Japan and China, do you think this is the biggest rivalry in table tennis today?
I definitely think so. You know, there are so many Japanese players climbing up the world rankings. You see, in the women, there are four Japanese players in these top 16 in this tournament itself. I mean, that says a lot. And we did not even have world number three Mima Ito there. But in the men, I mean, they're also right up there.
Well, let's take a look here. Fang Zhendong, world number one at 24 years old, steamrolls through until the semifinals. Not a game drop to Patrick Franziska of Germany nor Jung Young Shik of Korea, but Wang Chuqin of China, a 4-2 semifinal that the internet is already buzzing about after just less than a day of having that video posted on YouTube. But on the other side of the table, somebody who's gone through a lot already at 15 years old, was already number three in the world, Tomokazu Harimoto. He's 18 years old, and yes, he was on the half of the bracket that had the Chinese players eliminated. And interestingly enough, that's credit to Quadri Aruna and Ugo Calderano. But Tomokazu Harimoto getting through his opponents, including Matthias Falk, the silver medalist of 2019 at the World Championships without dropping a game. Wang Chunting, the top pen holder in this tournament in the men's here, and period. And Ugo Calderano 4-1. I don't think the world expected that. Ugo Calderano has been in outstanding form, and at the World Championships went way deeper than Tomokazu Harimoto. But I think for the last two World Championships in 2019, being beaten by An Jae-hyun, the number 10 player from Korea, they could only send five. He was number 10, and he beat one of the top-seeded players, Tomokazu Harimoto. And this year, just a week ago, Jakub Dias of Poland. In the early round, round of 64, Harimoto had a bye through 128, so I think he really was hungry to show the world what he's made of. He's physically a different player than he was 2 years ago by quite a bit, and I think he's going to be a man on a mission here tonight.
Yeah, I think those World Championship losses shouldn't deter him, because he's only 18. He's got at least, I'd say, six World Championships left to play.
First game, Harimoto to serve.
Let's see. Best of seven match, Harimoto to start with the serves. Well, that's not exactly what he's going to hope for. Fang Zhendong with any loose ball, just even a centimeter, he'll take it. Just the same the other way. The ball comes just barely off the back of the table, only allowing for a slow spinny shot from Fang Zhendong. And that's what Harimoto capitalizes on. Good start to the point, but you can see the quads just carrying Fang Zhendong to anywhere he needs to be to counter.
Yeah, he gets so low on that forehand topspin of his, especially the ones played from his backhand side, when he gets a little bit of his body out of the way.
Now, this is two balls that have been within reach for Harimoto that have just sort of bent and dipped and dived out of the way of his racket. Smart play, leans the upper body out of the way and plays the short side of the table. Not a lot of long rallies yet.
Yeah, but I'm sure we are going to see many of them coming right up. 2-3, he's trying to make use of his serve.
Nice change of pace here, slows it down. You know, Fang Zhendong has a lot of power, a lot of ammunition. But if you can break his rhythm, I mean, table tennis has so much to do with rhythm. So this is a very clever shot from Harimoto. Players doing the right thing to play until they're sure the let is called. Let called just before. Powerful shot. Ooh, back edge of the table. Defensive, just a block from behind the table from Tomo.
Yeah, that was played with a lot of pace from Zhendong. but an excellent return from the Japanese player.
Good length here, keeping it inside the table, right at the baseline, a half-long push. Pays off for Harimoto.
Yeah, good return from him. Just slightly high, but enough of underspin on the ball.
This is a lot of work to make a quality attack on this ball. Fong Zhendong has to be so tight to the table there. He swings like there's nothing possibly in the way. A lot of people would be just shy of even getting near the table when it's that close. Very ambitious shot here. You could hear the sound of his less rotation on it. I feel like I just won something. I saw two cherries in the crowd. I don't know if that means you win something. We have seen some fun outfits here from some of the fans in the crowd, the Popeye crew yesterday. Some digital cheering boards saying Jiayou for their Chinese players. Fong Zhendong here.
The last shot, the backhand, he just tried to play the slow backhand open, but again, the shorter part of the table down the line.
It's been back and forth throughout here. They were 3-3 at the last towel break, and then Harimoto took a small lead. And here was Fong Zhendong in front, but tied up. Second towel break. Again, every 6 points, towel breaks are allowed, not mandatory. Chance for players to dry their sweat, get ready, but the crowd here pretty clearly behind Xiaopeng, Fong Zhendong. Perfect placement when it's in near the net. Instead of trying to go wide to the corners, he hits it right into the body in just no time to get the racket up.
Yeah, Zhendong was expecting the ball to be played cross court. He just went straight down the center.
I start to think to myself, you know, I've been watching a lot of table tennis over the years. Speaking of Harimoto, there's Yu Harimoto, the father and coach for Tomokazu Harimoto, former provincial player in China. Him and his wife moved to Japan, started a table tennis club and a family. And now they live over that table tennis club. And I'd probably say inside it a good amount of the time. But I was going to say, head-to-head, they've played 5 times, and Fong Zhendong has won 4 of them, yes. But that leaves one. Tomokazu won in 2018 at the Asian Cup. It was a best of 5. That was a 3-1 victory. Here, this is best of 7. So the law of averages would favor Fong Zhendong even more. But still, Harimoto leads by 1. And a long push, not surprising Fong Zhendong. He holds his ground well, waits patiently there for the opening attack, doesn't commit early.
An excellent backhand topspin on the service return from Zhendong.
That was interesting. Did you see the hand of the umpire? There was a little bit of indecision here. Look at it one more time. This camera angle will be very interesting. Yeah, good. Shot is good.
Yeah.
Proper call, Fong Zhendong's point. It isn't always so easy to tell. From different angles, you have different views. But now, 2 game points, that's 3 points in a row for world number 1. 4.
Yeah.
That's 1 more than 3.
Harimoto led 8-6, and Zhendong now has game points.
Push to get into it. Fong Zhendong taking care of business, but not without a fight. From down 6-8, he gets 5 points in a row in the world number 1, showing what end game means. You can start well, but it's whoever ends well that wins the match. Here's another look at game point. Fong Zhendong with that pendulum serve. in right away. Long push to the baseline, and now it is an open force field. Perfect placement there into the elbow. So as Qing Zhijian talks to Fang Zhendong. Both get ready, they've got 1 minute to come back. A look at the world rankings right now. Top 10 in the world, Fang Zhendong on top by more than 2,000 points in front of a player that we don't know if we will see play again. And behind him, I mean, 4,000 points below world number one is the world number three, who we don't know if we'll see play again. Ugo Calderano, Tomokazu Harimoto might move up and take those second and third spots, but there's still some distance between them and the world number two. Silent Assassin in number six. Dmitry Ovcharov has been injured, which is really tough for him. I mean, he played an incredible Olympic Games and couldn't play the World Championships nor here despite qualifying. So very interesting time right now for table tennis. A lot of turbulence in the rankings, but these two will be in the game for a long time. I'll be curious to see, especially with the new ranking system, there's a lot more movement. I mean, every week, new, you know, world rankings come out. So it's sort of fun to keep track of and see who's moving and where the rankings are going.
The players here obviously have an extra advantage of getting ranking points. The ones who aren't here, well, they just have to stay where they are in the rankings. Oh, how quick was that? How quick was that? Harimoto had played an excellent forehand topspin, but look at this reaction from Zhendong. A very short backswing and a clear winner.
Oh, beautiful counter to get right back in. Even with the rhythm break, Fang Zhendong, he gets so much power. Bruce Lee is his favorite actor. And the one-inch punch is like his backhand. Watch him just generate so much power. One shot there, barely any backswing. Funny, you mentioned the ones who aren't here will have to just stay in the world rankings. Unfortunately for them, others will climb over them. If you're not earning, you might be depreciating in value. Not only are they playing for world ranking points here, $600,000.
Wow, this is real pace shown by the world champion. Both with forehand and backhand, he's just not letting Harimoto into these rallies. Taking the ball very early, high wrist shots, but he's pulling them off.
Fired up a bit. It's interesting. This is one of the many things that Harimoto is known for, his fighting spirit and vocalizing when he plays. For him, it just relieves him of stress. He's talked about it in interviews. Now, this is a tough one. Very spinny. Fang Zhendong slows it down, and Harimoto has to hold back as he's turning the corner. Very different scoreline than we saw in the first game.
Yeah, the first game, they were neck to neck. I actually said at some point in the match that we might see long rallies, but then again, we may not, because they both play such hard shots, such powerful shots, high wrist shots, you know. So it's so tough for the other person to return.
Yeah, there's a lot of TNT out here, a lot of explosive power on both sides. 5 points in front and 4 points away from a second game. Finds an angle that's out of reach. Good use of side spin on this to bend it out and make it curve out of reach to the wide forehand.
Yeah, the first time we've seen the down-the-line backhand from Harimoto. This is one of his favorite shots.
This time down the middle as well. Backhand over the table game is very aggressive. I think this is one thing that Harimoto, I think one of the key ingredients for why he's been so effective and why he's got wins against most of the top Chinese players. But well played here. Fang Zhendong leaves it near the table. Not a lot of wiggle room there for Harimoto to make contact cleanly.
Yeah, just a very short return, taken very early, almost on the bounce. And that angle so short to the extreme forehand.
Back edge of the table. They've got a lot of back and forth, edge balls, nets. I think that's just the extra pressure to play shots that are deep, extra deep, and shots that are low to the net, extra low to the net.
Yeah. The long push attempted by Zhendong, slightly long. And Harimoto's done well here. He's won the last couple of points. He was 4-8 down. And he won both the points on Zhendong's serve.
There's that wide line again. Good exit angle here. Harimoto making a move back into this game from quite a deficit at 1-5 at the first towel break.
Yeah, what a strong wrist he needs to play that shot. From his extreme forehand, going cross-court away from Zhendong's forehand.
The apology for that net ball. A lot of people ask why. Why do you apologize when you hit the net or the edge? Isn't it part of the game?
No, but there's so much of a difference in the spin then. I mean, you're playing for one shot and then you have to suddenly change direction when the ball clips the net.
Basically some fortune that was unintended. Corner to corner, coast to coast. Harimoto making his opponent run the most. A chasing backhand here. Fang Zhendong has got the biggest sweet spot in the men's game. How did he get just about, what's that, about 7-8 feet over, just in a heartbeat? And he doesn't even know if that's exactly where Harimoto was gonna go. So now Harimoto in the lead. Two game points for the 18-year-old Tomokazu Harimoto. It's funny, him and his dad both have the same sort of timing on the eye blinks. They have a similar blinking pattern that is not common to most people. Not even within the Harimoto family. His mom and his sister don't have that same blink.
What a comeback in this game from the Japanese player. He was 4-8 down, he's now 10-8 up.
Ooh, doesn't miss by a lot. Takes a guess, gets in position, gets the racket high. So after six in a row, bit of a streak broken here. Fang Zhendong 1 point away from getting right back into this at deuce. But it's Harimoto with the handcuffing serve to take game two. It's a best of seven match. And the show has only just begun, one game apiece. We'll see who takes the lead in game three. But Harimoto right now with a bit of momentum, and he came to battle. It's been a while since he's pulled off some big upsets over the Chinese opposition. But we know that he's capable of it. He has been since he was 14 years old, and maybe even earlier. Here's another look at how he did it, that tight serve that carries just long on the receive. What do you think Fang Zhendong has to do to shut down Harimoto?
Zhendong has played well. I think he was in control of that second game, but then 6 points in a row he let go. That's very unusual from the world number one. But it's okay. It's only one game apiece. He's right. I mean, at 1-1, both the players are right in this match. And look at the shots. Some of these shots from Harimoto. He's getting the returns that he wants. He's going for forehand winners, couple of backhand shots, that one down the line. And he's done very well to win this game.
Well, you can see that he's earned it. His passion, there's no question about it. This is one of the things I love for Harimoto. No one wants to see someone playing who they feel is not giving it their all. You're representing our country. You're representing our flag. Fight for us. Harimoto fights for every point. Like he's carrying the entire nation of Japan with it. And that forehand flick so good inside the table.
Getting the short return that he wanted, and what a beautiful forehand flick.
The ball hit his face on the toss. Very fair play. Fang Zhendong, you might wonder how much English does he know? He knows enough. Said face. Once the ball's tossed, it can't hit your shirt, your face. Basically, it can't hit anything other than your racket or the hand holding the racket. Take a look. Can we see? Ah, interesting. On the way down, Harimoto very quick to admit it. As fair can be. Harimoto's a fighter, but he's also a gentleman. I mean, he does the right thing. I don't think I've ever seen him on the wrong side of a controversy. And I've seen him in controversies, but he handles it always like a gentleman. It's a very respectful sort of like, let's talk this out. Even when he disagrees with someone, it's always like, but I'm willing to hear what you have to say. And I like that.
So after winning the first point in this third game, Harimoto has lost four in a row, but he's got one more serve to come.
Turns his back, puts everything into this shot on the step round. I don't think I can recall the last time I saw Harimoto take a shot like this. Touch shot there, cradles the ball with side and underspin. Keeps an eye on it for a minute, but realizes there's no turning back at this point. It's a gamble, and it pays off. So out of the first towel break, 2 points between them now. A little bit off the top of the net. Again, the reason players apologize for that is it's not intended, but they can often benefit from it. Very tough for a player to recover when a ball just slows down and drops over like that or hits the edge. Oh, fired up on the receive, three in a row after the four that Fang Zhendong saw.
Very quick backhand return. That wasn't a slow topspin at all. That was hit with a lot of pace.
They're going back and forth here with momentum, as we saw in last game as well. I mean, they get streaky, and then they seem to ride that confidence and really go with it. Extra bit of spin here. Fang Zhendong, we've seen so many slow-mos throughout his career, him over the table. But here's a look at Harimoto trying to stay on top of the heavy topspin that jumps up off the bounce. And a surprise deep push here.
Yeah, very nice deep push from Zhendong. Harimoto was trying to play the backhand topspin, but the ball was hit very deep off his body. So 3 points in a row for Zhendong.
Good turn this time. The long push doesn't fool Harimoto. He's not committed. He's ready at the back of the table.
Going for this outright forehand winner. So much of power behind that shot. Full body weight behind that shot, but going forward. And how good was that? A couple of times now he's gotten Zhendong not able to play the forehand block.
Funny, Fang Zhendong, I feel like block is sort of like an allergy of his. He just doesn't do it. When he blocks, he's always adding topspin. He's always doing something more with the wrist to just add that bit of aggression to the opponent. But two in a row here, chance to tie it up for Harimoto. Outstanding play, clever early in this rally. Harimoto looked like he was going to attack, and he pushed. And then he got a weaker shot out of Fang Zhendong to set up a fifth ball.
How good was this shot from Zhendong, the one going cross court? But Harimoto was up to it, and then, you know, Zhendong just couldn't get out of the way.
Good placement there by Harimoto into the body. Oh.
the backhand open. He had played it beautifully a few shots ago. And this time just long, but then so much of variation and spin on that serve.
I think this is the right shot to go for. He's got to take his chances, seize an opportunity there. If he plays that passively, Fang Zhengdong was in position to come in for the push. He wasn't backing off too quickly. On the line here, gutsy shot. Remember, it's a best of seven. But this is still a fairly pivotal turning point in the first part of this match. And a timeout on Fang Zhengdong's side. Interesting.
Yeah.
I wish I could have shown you Varsha's face just there. Now, this is the second time we've seen a timeout called by Chinese players quite early, but here it's with a coach in the corner. This is the trend. Earlier and earlier timeouts. I like to think of it like refurnishing your home. The sooner you do it, the longer you get to live enjoying the new furniture and the luxury of living there. If you have wisdom early on that could help you, you don't want to be behind the eight ball here. You don't want to be chasing to come back. You want to set the tone early. So we'll see. I think the time to call a timeout is whenever you think it'll change the outcome of the match. A wise friend from Colombia told me that. How about you?
Yeah, probably a good time for Zhengdong. He knows this is an important game. It's actually an important game for both the players at one all. Whoever wins this goes ahead in the match. But he feels it's not only the next point, it's also the points after that when he gets served back. Even if it's 9-all, he's got two serves to come. But if it's 10-8, I mean, he's going to be in a much better position.
Now, here's a question for you. In terms of tired, you know, fatigue even, mental or physical, Fang Zhengdong played till the very last day at the World Championships. Harimoto had training slash vacation after his first match in singles. Yes, in doubles he played more, but events-wise, I mean, how much of a factor do you think freshness is, recovery time, with this long flight in the back-to-back tournaments?
I mean, I think it's all adrenaline right now, yeah? I mean, Zhengdong has played a match a day here, while yesterday we saw Harimoto play two matches, the quarterfinal and the semifinal.
Good point.
That timeout seems to have worked in Zhengdong's favor. He's got serve back 10-8.
Nice parallel backhand after the slow spinny one. Harimoto chasing, and he's within 1 point. If he can take this game, not only will he have the lead, but he'll have his opponent without a timeout for the rest of this best of seven match. Ooh, right near the back of the table, a very perfectly placed half-long push. And it's Fang Zhengdong to take the 2-1 lead. The timeout has paid off, Varsha.
Yeah, I mean, he was shaping up initially to play that third ball attack, changed his mind at the very last second and played the push instead, the deep push, which Harimoto could not connect.
Now, if you're newer to table tennis, just to sort of fill you in, when I say half long, the difference is short will bounce on the table twice clearly. Long will come off the table clearly. But a half long push, you can't tell if it's going to come off or not. And this one, right there, in between. Yes, it comes off the table, but by so little that Harimoto, I mean, he's fearless. He cut his hand open and bled like crazy last time he was in this part of the world. Playing in T2, he went for an attack and caught the edge of the table right there below his thumb. And I remember the shot of Bernie Such's face reacting to it, bleeding immediately. But what about Fang Zhengdong covering the middle and how he moves out there? His coverage has been really strong, even with his racket up. This is that allergy to block. As soon as the table's off, or excuse me, as soon as the ball is off the table, block is not part of his vocabulary.
Yeah, he takes the ball very early, always in good position.
Back to serve. Love ball.
Just thinking about how complete of a player Fan Zhendong is. Someone asked me recently, have you ever seen him chop? The answer is yes. He said a lot, I said no. Oh, blasting backhand again. The amount of time from it that it takes from when Fan Zhendong decides he's gonna hit it with his backhand to the time you have to get your racket up is almost nothing.
Getting off to the perfect start in game number four, the world champion. Just looks like he's upped a gear a bit.
Good angle here, moving in early. One of the many advantages of being closer to the table and taking the ball earlier. Not only does your opponent have less time to react, but you've got more choices in terms of where you can play at a much wider, more obtuse angle.
Excellent backhand topspin from Zhendong. Just see how low he gets when he plays that ball.
I was just thinking it's so impressive how he's ready for almost anything. Like you have to guess what's Harimoto gonna do to throw off Fan Zhendong. And when he brings a long push, he doesn't seem very surprised. He's right there and ready. A good extra topspin on this for security. Change the timing a bit and it gets blocked up and out. Whoa. Gets blocked up and out. Fan Zhendong blocked. Good for you, Harimoto. Wow. And an empty serve looks like heavy underspin, but the point of contact, he doesn't brush the ball as much, just stops contacting it a little more flat. And that open face of the racket facing towards the ceiling from Fan Zhendong would have handled heavy underspin, but it pops up and out. It's a good opportunity here that Harimoto earned, but Fan Zhendong isn't easy to play, and he's there in position always.
Yeah, both the players here playing the short balls, preventing the other from attacking, and Harimoto here saw his opening. Good attempt. The slower forehand topspin from Zhendong, bending low again, almost from net height.
A bit more punchy on the backhand. He's in position to catch it early on the rise before Fan Zhendong has a chance to really settle. That's a big point. You don't want to be down 3-7 and 1-2 in games. That was the moment where it was sort of like the pinata was starting to break open. Good control. Right inside the table. Fan Zhendong takes it early off the bounce. How much have we seen throughout this tournament? Quick decisions allowing players a lot of options.
Oh yeah, table tennis is all about very quick decisions. It's all about anticipation as well. So if you anticipate correct, you've made the correct decision to move wherever you want, and then you get the ball where you want, then it's all about reaction.
It's funny, you just brought that up, and Fan Zhendong for the first time anticipated here a shorter serve and started to step in. But Harimoto surprises him with that long serve to the backhand, and he has to backpedal, reset. By the way, Fan Zhendong did not just lick his racket, he breathed on it to get a little fog there to clean off the dust for better traction. Little off the top of the net on the opening attack, but Harimoto within 1 point now.
Harimoto upping his pace in that last rally. One going cross court and the last one down the line. He apologizes as one of the shots just clipped the net.
Seven, six.
That's just outstanding. I love it. What are you thinking, Varsha?
Oh, my God. Look at those shots. Played from well away from the table. How often do we see this from Jindong? These are not just, you know, casual returns or just... These are not high percentage shots.
Right. I think if you can make low percentage shots a high percentage of the time, you're going to be dangerous to play. And that's the name of Fang Zhendong's game. But here it's Harimoto over the table, returning the favor. Over the table is such an important part of the game. If you can really force your opponent to play inside the table, you're going to have a massive advantage being able to attack from there. Not easy to do with these low shots coming in.
The backhand open this time from Jindong goes to the center of the table, and Harimoto just got caught a little bit. He wanted to play the, he didn't really want to play the forehand topspin, but he just got caught up.
I think the ball was played. Spin.
Yeah, yeah.
Fang Zhendong giving the Chiquita with heavy side spin, and that's very tough to counter. It takes a jump off the bounce. Clever idea. He's got Fang Zhendong way behind the table. Says, let me slow it down, take some pace off. But he finds the net. Not easy to do to slow down a ball that's moving this fast with heavy topspin. Three game points for Fang Zhendong, world number one, the world champion, to take a 3-1 lead. And that's all he needs, the serve, and that is it. He's one game away from a title at the inaugural WTT Cup Finals, the Singapore edition. 11-7, the most controlling game he's had yet, which says a lot about the quality of every game in this match. I mean, it is the biggest difference we've seen between the two so far.
Yes, both players giving it all they have. Jindong just, I think, in the crucial stages, he's coming up with the big shots. Harimoto's playing very well, of course, but not able to string enough points together, like maybe three or four together at one time to take any kind of lead. And he's always playing catch-up.
Just a look at the fans here. You can see the Chinese flags and the banners for their favorite player, Xiaopeng. That's Little Fatty in Chinese, meaning Fang Zhendong, world number one. Ooh, lights around the board there? That is probably the cutest sign I've ever seen. And we've got some digital signs there as well with the Jiayou. If you're ever in the table tennis world, let's see here, Fang Zhendong. A lot of Chinese fans here. Wherever table tennis goes, so do the Chinese fans. Wow. If I'm gonna guess, I'm gonna say Dongge, as in brother Dong, Fang Zhendong. My reading in Chinese is not so good. My reading in any language, really. I like picture books, personally. Coloring is fun for me. One game to three. Harimoto starting it off. It's not going to be easy. It's never going to be easy against world number one. But when he's got confidence, he's got wiggle room on the scoreboard. All pressure right now on the world number five, Tomokazu Harimoto.
Tried the outright winner there on the third ball, but I think balls are coming back with interest right now. The harder he's hitting it, the harder they're coming back.
No! He just went around the net post in this rally. That is a spectacular shot. I mean, unless I saw it wrong, it looked like he just slid the ball on the table around the net. He just saved himself a timeout, too. If he loses that point, quote me, he goes for a timeout. But that is a big bite of confidence for Harimoto.
The serve just slightly long enough for Harimoto to play the forehand topspin.
Good pressure here as Fang Zhendong stays on top of the bounce and near the table in this rally. That rally that you saw, watch this, wider. Top of the net, oh man, that's gotta be one of the best shots of the tournament. I mean, he's challenging Fang Zhendong for his around the net backhand, but that ball barely comes up. You do not have to hit it over the net. And that's one of the toughest things about it when your opponent hits an around the net shot. If they hit it around the net and it's high, well, that's like saying I know a shortcut, but then jumping over the height of a gate anyway. You might as well hit it lower than the net if you're going to go around the net. And that's exactly what Harimoto did. So the ball stays very low off the bounce. Very patient play here. Harimoto spins it back a little more for security. It's easy to crumble under the pressure of trying to outspeed Fang Zhendong.
I think Fang actually took one ball that clipped the edge of the table.
He recovered Harimoto's edge ball?
Yeah, I think so.
Jeez. Now that first ball from Harimoto surprised Fang Zhendong, but after that, Fang Zhendong was right there and ready for everything. It was tough to find a place to catch him off guard, and here's the timeout. Little father-son moment in the corner. What do you think the conversation is, Varsha?
I think, well, you know, normally before when we used to see Harimoto call a timeout and go towards his dad, I mean, he would be the one speaking, but now I think he's just waiting for all the instructions to be given by his father. Good time to call a timeout. He's trailing 1-3 and by 2 points here. But he's got serve to come. So he needs to feel that he can still get these couple of points and keep even with Zhendong. It's very tough because the level at which the world number one is playing is really, really high. The balls are coming at Harimoto very quickly, taken very early and almost on the bounce from Zhendong. So it's going to be an uphill struggle, but Harimoto is one player who you feel is going to give it everything he has. And this is the time he needs to do it.
Time indeed. The 1 minute clock has come to an end. So both players have pulled their lifelines. There are no more timeouts in this best of seven match. Fang Zhendong is 6 points away from becoming the champion.
3-5.
So back from the timeout. Little talk with dad, Yu Harimoto in the corner. Tomokazu to serve.
Left. 3-5.
Oh!
That's one you just have to sit back and watch. You go for the shot, you realize you're way out of position, not worth the injury. That push was so deep. Fang Zhendong just spinning it to the exact opposite side of the table. But short side, he's here this time around. I wonder, psychologically, if you win a point from there, and it's happened, I've seen it several times. If Harimoto wins that point, Fang Zhendong is going to have, I'd say, a different level of nerve in his game. Right now, 2 point lead back to Fang Zhendong. And he just sort of inches closer here to the finish line.
Yeah, what a good serve that was from Zhendong. So much of underspin on the ball. There was no chance for Harimoto to attack that shot, to attack that serve, and 3 point lead.
One thing I really like about Fang Zhendong is in this moment, he looks down at his equipment. The ball doesn't grip the way he expected it to, but there wasn't a sense of blame. A lot of players, me included, will look at the racket to say, what happened? Like, I know I did what I wanted to do. Why didn't you go where I intended you to go?
Sometimes there's also a little bit of sweat on the racket that causes the ball to just fall flat on that side of the table.
This is why you see, it's the responsibility of the server, why you'll see the players clean off their racket, and why you'll see the server rub the ball in their pocket sometimes, their shirt, or just their hand to dry it off. Chole indeed. Fan Zhendong's back up by three. He's got two serves. If he converts them both, he cleanly takes the title, only dropping one game. Sure feels like home crowd for Fan Zhendong right now. And a strong effort, but pinning that elbow. It's Fan Zhendong now sitting on five championship points. Champion 2 weeks in a row, undefeated, world number one, shown and proved. Congratulations, Xiao Pong. You have not only lived up to your top billing, but you have reminded the world what they have to work for and the bar that has been set so high to inspire the rest of the world to come and catch you at the top of the game.